Oh boy.
Do your grave and go buy two. She eat a big dick and she don't use a spoon. I hop in the foreign and then it goes zoom. She too attached, think I need me some room. Talk about my bro, but it'll be out at noon. They dumped me until I broke out my cocoon. If I catch him lacking, your homie is doomed. We clean this block, 30 shots out the broom. Half piss and pop out like it's toast. Hit that bitch once and I gotta go ghost. She see I got power, now she do the most. Internet gangsters get mad, make a post. Bet you I win, but my back is the rope. Rocking off white, so she think I'm the Pope. I jumped in the water, I knew I would float. You think you the best, and I'm killing a goat. Niggas was broke, all we had was hope. Bro hit the plug, all he had was dope. I get the last laugh if he think it's a joke. Say she got a friend, well I want them both. Ain't going to jail like me up in the booth. Talk out your mouth, then you might lose a tooth. Bro to your scorer, all he know is shoot. I'm dropping the top, I think I lost my roof. Don't listen to him.
What's good, everybody? Welcome back to the Oregon State Dynasty, coming off a big-time win over UCLA, 70-3, an absolute demolition. If you missed it, be sure to go check it out. I will tag it in the top right corner right here. This was something we had to do, especially in this game, because, as you know, it was a massive recruiting weekend. 11 guys on hand to see this game and watch us blow out the Bruins. I think we hit all the visiting bonuses as well. So it should be a good weekend for us. Let's take one more look at who came in on the visits this week, just so you guys know who we're looking at, who might commit in the next matter of seconds. So we had Ryan Stevens, Reggie Brown, Jeremy Carter, Patrick Adams, Clifton Rivero, not Buck Ward. He'll be coming in week 8. Jonathan Maxwell, Kevin Moore, Ben Hart, Harold Russell, Aaron Smith, and then Kevin Gibson at the bottom. So that's the list of guys. We played really well. We showed them everything they could have possibly wanted to see. So let's find out who's going to commit to the team and how our class be looking after week 5. All right, this is it. Here we go. Seconds away from seeing the list. Here we go. Look at all that yellow, baby. I can already see 6 commitments on the board and several more probably in the bottom. Let's go. It was a big recruiting weekend. We knew that going in, and we reaped the benefits of it with a massive, massive list of additions to our 2027 recruiting class. Let's scroll down and see if we got anybody else. Oh, of course we do. We got 2 more guys. So if you do your math correctly, that's 8 commitments, as you can see off the top of your head. One guy actually committed to Washington State there, which sucks, but 8 commitments out of 11 guys that visited. That's not bad. That's over 75%, over the majority of the guys that were there. They must have been talking with each other, saying, hey, if you commit, I'll commit. But big time. Probably one of the best recruiting weekends we've had on this dynasty ever. I'm not sure that we've ever had 8 guys commit at once like that. And that's going to take up pretty much half of our class already. So now we have maybe 7-8 guys left. We'll take a look at it, of course. But here's a look at the updated board. We'll come back to the guys that are at the top and see how we're looking on them, the guys that haven't committed yet. But Brett Peterson here, this one free safety, commits to Wazoo. I mean, that's fine if you want to get your butt kicked, you know, once a year by us every time you play us. That's fine with me, because we have Jonathan Maxwell, who I'll show you guys in just a second here. I think he's the better guy anyway. So you know what? You can have him, Wazoo. Take your mans. Starting with Aaron Smith, one of the most underrated players in this class, 3-star linebacker out of Texas, and this is why he's underrated. 83 speed, 90 acceleration, 70 tackles, 60 hit power, all good numbers for a linebacker. You can't teach that kind of speed. Harold Russell, 6'3", 281 out of New Jersey. My little brother really likes this guy. I do too. I'm not like as high on him as he is. He thinks he's going to be a first rounder, but we'll see. He's got good speed, good length, good bend around the edge. Moving on, we have Ben Hart, 3-star fullback. I don't really care too much about this one. He was a bust, but I think he's athletic enough to be good enough in our system for what we need the fullback to do. And, you know, it's a fullback, so we just had to fill that roster spot, and we did. Kevin Moore, 6'7", 284. That is insane size. He's out of Louisiana, and that's a talent hotbed for sure. 81 pass block, 76 run block, 70 impact block. Also, 94 acceleration. That'll come in handy because, you know, we like to test the perimeter and everything. Here's Jonathan Maxwell, 4-star out of Arizona, 6'1", little under 200 pounds, but he's really fast. 88 speed, 88 excel, 86 agility, which is important, 81 tackle. So he's got all the things you'd want in a free safety. Patrick Adams, we added 2 more D tackles. He's got good size, almost about 300 pounds, 85 power move, 77 finesse, 77 block shed, and 75 tackle as well. Jeremy Carter, 4-star out of California, Pipeline State. He's 6'3", 262. so a little bit smaller, but he's also taller. 77 power move, 77 finesse, and it's a really good tackle, so he had a great offer list. And then there's Reggie Brown. I think he's going to be the best player in this class. 86 speed, 84 excel, 68 tackles, 67 hit power, 70 man coverage, 69 zone coverage, and 75 agility. He's going to be an absolute stud wherever he plays. 6'2", 235. All right, so those are the guys that have committed. Like I said, we filled out pretty much half of our class. Brian Stevens is the number one guy on our board, the five-star athlete out of Oregon. We need to get him. He visited. He enjoyed his time. He's just going to think it over a little bit, it seems like. So, you know, we'll see where that recruitment goes. Clifton Rivera, we're still in first for him. Buck Ward still has to come in on his visit in week 8. He just went to Texas A&M and watched them get blown out by somebody. So that's a good sign for us. Usually when you do a visit, you surge into first place in a battle, but they didn't. So that means we've pretty much locked up first place in that recruiting battle for now. Here's an updated look at what we need in this class. So we've signed 10 guys. There's 18 seniors leaving. So that means we have 8 more scholarships left, and that's guaranteed. There could be some juniors that go pro. Usually I try to convince them to come back and stay because they're not ready for the league yet, but there might be some guys that could go pro this year, and you know, we'll see how that all kind of shakes out. But I just plan for the seniors leaving and fill those spots up. Justin McQueen, another guard. I've brought in some tackles. I want to bring in a couple more guards as well because we have the spot to do that, so we're going to leave him there. Jacob Taylor, 3-star free safety out of Alabama. I'd love to keep Alabama a pipeline state, but I can't bring in a prospect just for the sake of bringing in a prospect, especially when we only have 8 spots left in this recruiting class. And I just don't think he could play anywhere else but safety. And obviously, we brought in Maxwell, and he's going to hold it down at free safety. So what's the point of bringing in a backup to him if they're going to be the same year, right? You're going to get 1 year out of him as a starter 5 years down the line. Doesn't make any sense. So we're going to cut him. Sean Hunter, another guard, 6'3", 280s, and only offer is from us. I think he's a little underrated. He's from New Jersey, so we're going cross country for him. Then there's Ed Lewis. We have a 6'7 tackle already. I want to bring in a 6'6 tackle, but it looks like App State's winning that battle, and I don't want to put too much energy and stock into that bet. I'm not fighting against App State. If you really want to go to App State that bad, you go ahead, man. I'm giving you a scholarship to come play the best football team in America. And you don't want to do it, that's fine. John Moore, not any good. We've already brought in some defensive ends anyway, and he's just going to be a spot filler, and I want some guys that can actually make an impact in this program. Here's Kevin Gibson. He just visited. That's why I run first for him, and I just offered him a scholarship. I don't know why he didn't commit. He's the type of player where if you get a scholarship from a school like us, you should commit right away. But Derek Tyler does that. Let's go. So Gibson may have just lost his spot on this team because Derek Tyler's coming in. 6'6", 285, another player out of Louisiana. That's how it works, man. I'm going to offer you a scholarship. We ain't got all the time in the world. And for that matter, I don't really give a crap about you. You're a low 3-star. If you get a scholarship from the number one team in the country, you should commit on the spot. He didn't. Tyler does. That spot is his. And now we're down to 7 guys left in this recruiting class. We already have an instant commit on the offensive line down at the bottom. Ricardo Berg, who committed way, it feels like a long time ago, but this class is shaping up really, really well. So we have 6 guys on the board. We have 7 spots available. So what does that mean? We got to go back to the cycle. We got to dip back into the bucket, find some more talent to bring in, find some more talent to scout, because the guys on the board, you know, we're going to have 1 extra spot left to go, and I don't want to leave that spot unused. So let's put 700 on Kevin Gibson, and let's go back to the drawing board and look for some more players. Before we do that, though, just want to look at the updated recruiting standing. So we're in first by a healthy margin. Next best team is USC. We have 10 commitments. We are, actually, it's 11 now once they update next week. We are absolutely loaded, and we are rolling on the recruiting trail, getting things started early, locking dudes up early in the season. That's how I like to play it. But anyways, let's go back to the recruiting board, take a look at some of our commitments, 40 times and bench press and squat numbers, and then look for some more guys that could potentially become commits later on. So we'll start with Jeremy Carter. Don't care about the 40. He's a defensive lineman. 425 bench, 605 squat. Great numbers. Ricardo Berg, 435 and 585. So, you know, as long as you're around that ballpark and you're a lineman, that's good for me. Adams, 440 and 580 on the squat. Now Maxwell, this is where we care about the 40 times. He's a safety. 446, great speed, and he's pretty strong too. 350 bench, 355 squat. Reggie Brown runs a 4.5 flat as a linebacker. That's insane. 360 bench and 520 squat. Oh my lord. Now we got McDonald. He is 450 and 570 bench and squat respectively. Moving all the way down to Aaron Smith, another linebacker. He also runs a 4.5 40, 4-5-6 to be specific, but a 4-5-40, that's insane. Him and Brown are going to team up and be studs. 365 on the bench, 535 on the squat. Harold Russell runs a 4-6 as a defensive end, and he's, what, 281 pounds? That's pretty darn good. 395-20 bench and squat. Ben Hart, the fullback, runs a quiet 4-6. That's very impressive for a fullback, but his squat is not good. I mean, he barely squats more than his body weight, and that's kind of a problem, but, you know, we'll work on that. 400 and 585 for Moore on the offensive line, and then Tyler here at the bottom has 390 and 570 to his credit, and that should be pretty much everybody. So, with that said, really impressive 40 times from the dudes that need to be fast, and really good numbers in the gym for the guys that I need to be strong. So, that's always good to see. We got some speed, man, at all positions. 4-5 for a linebacker, you do not see that all the time. For reference, Manti Te'o ran a 4-8, okay? You don't see 4-5s or 4-4s out of linebackers very often, so that's why I'm so excited about these guys. You can't teach speed, you can teach everything else. But anyways, I'm looking to add a little more skill position talent to this class. I feel like we're lacking that. There's no quarterbacks, there's no running backs, there's no wide receivers. So I want to try to add a couple of running backs, add a couple of wide receivers, and pick one skill position guy that can come in and be a difference maker as a freshman. So we're just going to go through and add guys with low locks that were in the top three or four, even top five. I don't really care because we can surge up in a matter of a week. So also an outside linebacker. I know I got two guys that are fast, but I think they project more as middle linebackers. They could play on the edge as well, but I want to bring in a true outside linebacker if possible. Because, you know, we have three guards on our board right now. I don't need all three. The first one to commit is coming in. Okay, I don't even know if I need any of them out of the three, but the first guy coming in is going to commit, and that's going to be how we decide that. First up, Maurice Paris, a little bit too slow for my liking. Don't really see a game changer in him. Marcus Witherspoon, same kind of deal. You can't be a running back at a power five level and have 85 speed and 83 excel. Same for Trent Coleman, just not good enough to play here. Somewhere else, definitely, but not good enough to play at Oregon State. Same for Cedric Lopez. I think I do leave him on the board momentarily because he's like 6'5", which is insane, but he's a possession receiver all the way. 83 speed, 79 excel. And how about Phil Hamm? Yes, that's what we like to see. 90 speed, 89 excel, 75 jumping, 82 route running. And let's take a look at his intangibles. He's 6'4", 200. Yeah. All right, so let's get Lopez out of here because we can get everything we want out of Lopez in Phil Hamm, and he's also faster. So we're going to go after him. He's from Alabama. How about Amir Sullivan? Maybe not terrible, 86, 84. Here's the problem, though. He's only 5'10", 171. If you're going to be that small and you want to play in the slot, man, you got to be blazing fast. He is not, so he's out of here. Ricky West, same kind of deal, 5'11". 80 acceleration, can't have that, man. I need some Tyreek Hill type speed in that position. We got two outside linebackers now. We'll start with Justin Yancey. He drops up 4 overall points. He's 6'3", 228. Not bad, 86 speed, 80 excel. I can work with that. It's not terrible. How about Chambers, though? Chambers jumps up 2. He's pretty fast, not the fastest guy in the world. He's a sure-handed tackler, though. Pretty good in coverage if you take a look at the comparison between the two. So I'm going to leave both on the board, and I think we're just going to go from there. We have about 2,000 points to spend, so let's go 700, 700 on Chambers, and the rest will go to Yancey because he's the lowest guy. As long as we get some points on him, we'll see how we can, you know, jump up in that race and see what kind of fluctuation there is there. But, you know, three guys that I can work with. I'm out of that list. I would hope to get Hamm. He seems like the biggest game changer to me. I don't know if we have a guy on our roster with that kind of height and speed combination. So if I have one scholarship to go, it'll probably go to him. And then if we cut those offensive guards, I can get Chambers, one of those two outside linebackers, just to shore up some depth, and they could potentially play in the future as well. So all good things. Really fun week of recruiting. The first time we've really gone in depth this year after the massive recruiting weekend. So I hope this was fun for you guys. Let's take a quick peek at the Heisman watch. McConnell is still in first place despite going for 34 yards on the ground and 35 through the air with one touchdown. Those are not Heisman-worthy numbers. I don't know if he's going to win it come season's end. I don't know, man. I don't know. I need him to pick it up a little bit, put up some bigger stat lines. But you know what? We're not really too interested in individual player stat lines as much as we are about winning every single time we take the field. So let's advance into week 6, actually a bye week, and then we'll get into Arizona in the week after that. All right, Arizona week, always some light chicken. That was the bye week, by the way. I don't know what I'm saying. We got one more commitment. Oh, Clifton Rivero. That is not the guy that insta-committed. That's what I thought it was at first glance, but Clifton Rivero has committed to the team. He's a three-star athlete, could play defensive line, could play on the offensive line like you just saw right there. So now we are down to six guys that could play for our that we could still bring in this year's recruiting cycle. But before we get into that, you guys see what I'm seeing? We got dropped from number one to number two after beating a team 70-3. All right, we'll take a look at it after this. I can't believe this happens every year, and I don't understand why it happens. But let's take a look at some updated numbers here. We'll start with Brian Stevens. We are just blowing away everybody else in this recruitment. I don't know what he's waiting for. Here's Averro. He's actually a four-star, 6'5", 280, out of our pipeline state nearby California. Had a great visit last week. He was a gem prospect, plus six on the trail, and I couldn't find his pass blocking numbers on here, but defensive line numbers look impressive, so he could play either position. It's really just about what we need more. With his size, I already have so many D tackles in this class, I'll probably put him on the offensive line, and with that, I think we might be done recruiting with the offensive line. I'm probably going to cut those offensive guards next recruiting episode, because I think I forgot to here, but that's going to be the plan of attack. We're going to go after some more skill position talent, but let's get into this debate about who's one and who's two, man. I don't understand this. All right, Penn State's number one. Usually when this happens, this team has played absolutely nobody, and that's the case again. One ranked win over a number 22 UCF team who has two losses, and it was by 14 points. Us, on the other hand, look at that. Count them. One, two, three ranked wins. At the time we played all of those teams, they were in the top five. And we started the season on the road with a big three-possession win over Syracuse, and we're coming off a 67-point win over UCLA. So I don't understand what the disconnect is here. I don't understand why we're the number two team in the country. But if you guys are OGs to the channel, you know this happens every single year. And all we do is just prove them wrong come season says. That's what we're going to do again. Let's get into drip of the day, though. I think this one's pretty obvious. If you watched the UCLA game, this dude, James Hughes, made a massive play. Big time forced fumble on the goal line to keep UCLA out of the end zone and preserve our, not shutout, but all they had was a field goal because they're a bunch of, I can't say the word, but they're a bunch of fraidy cats and wanted to kick a field goal down 28 points in the first or second quarter. Anyways, big time game from the freshman. This guy, his ceiling is the sky. He can go as high as he wants. He's going to be like Dwayne Patton 2.0. This guy's a dog. You're going to see why in the next couple years. Man, he looking nice with it. I'm really excited for James Hughes. Ever since I got him to commit last recruiting cycle, I knew he was going to be an absolute stud. I don't say that about a lot of guys, but definitely the case for Hughes, and he's just going to continue to get better and better and better and better every time he touches the field. He could play. He can get some more playing time with the starters, I think, in a nickelback role or something like that. All right, next thing we're going to do is, let's go Casey Williamson. He's been having a great season. I think he's either a sophomore or a junior, but he's really emerged on the defensive line this year. Has a couple of big-time sacks. Has really been a contributor in every game this season. So let's give him some love. Let's give him some drip here, and let's take care of that. All right, so James Hughes and Casey Williamson, your drip of the day candidates for this week. Big time game, really fun, and the recruiting really followed suit with that. We bring in a ton of commitments, and this is probably the most fun recruiting episode we've had this season. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Hit the subscribe button as well. We're on the road to 450 subscribers, and I'll be going home in the next few days, so stay tuned for some more one-on-one content between me and my little brother Colin. Those are always fun. Those are always bangers. So this is the place to be over the next 2 weeks, folks. Thanks again for watching. We got Arizona on the clock next. So excited for that one. Hope you are too. We will catch you then.